Hello everyone. So in today's session of Thoughtful Leaders, we have with us Dr. Om Prakash Rajankar, who is the academic dean and head of the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication at Dhole Patil College of Engineering. We heartily welcome you, sir, on our College Dunia platform. So with your permission, should we proceed with the questions?
Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay. Sir, my first question is, what is the latest program that you are offering in your institute which will help students outperform and stand apart from the crowd?
Okay. At Dhole Patil College of Engineering, we have total 6 programs: Automobile Engineering, Civil Engineering, Mechanical Engineering, Computer Engineering, Information Technology, and Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering. All the programs are affiliated to Pune University and are approved by AICT. Since 2019, the syllabus is revised and now it is more practical and skill-oriented. I think it will help the students outperform and stand apart from the crowd.
Okay, so moving on to the next question. What are the factors that makes this program the best for the students to opt?
I think Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering is one of the best engineering program because of the following 3 factors. First, the wide scope. You cannot imagine life without electronics. For example, electronics applications are at home, on the road, in industry, education, market, business, banking, advertising, communication, defense, medical, space and research. In fact, in every field, you will find applications of electronics. Second factor is, this is the emerging program. Every day, new applications are being developed. Instrumentation and controlling is becoming more and more precise due to the advancement in electronics devices. IoT, robotics, artificial intelligence, machine learning are the emerging fields based on VLSI and embedded electronics. And third factor is, this course is close to software. And due to this, electronics and telecommunication engineers can easily switch to software engineering as compared to other programs.
Okay, sir. Sir, tell me, what will you say the best practices in the courses you are offering?
Along with the core subjects, the course curriculum includes project-based learning, mini and major projects, employability skill development, and mandatory internship. I think rigorous teaching, learning, and follow-up process adopted in Electronics and Telecommunication Department is making the students competent.
Okay. Sir, what are some of the valuable insights of the program that you are offering at your institute?
Yes. Induction program, starting from the induction program, then industrial visits, lectures by industry experts, and internship gives sufficient exposure to students to make correct decision of choosing elective subjects and honors courses starting from third year of engineering. This helps them to prepare for future.
Okay. Sir, how does the program ensures that the students are being prepared for the future?
Yes, I think the answer I already given in the earlier question, that induction programs, industrial visits, lectures by industry experts, and internship gives sufficient exposure to students to make correct decision of choosing elective subjects and honor courses. Okay, so this is definitely helping them to prepare for future.
Okay. Sir, how do you train yourself and your faculty members to deliver this program to the students?
Yeah. Through faculty development programs, active participation in NPTEL courses of IITs, then industrial training, research work such as PhD, seminars, and workshops. Okay, shall I repeat?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Through faculty development programs, active participation in NPTEL courses, industrial training, research work such as PhD, seminars, webinars, workshops, etc., our faculty remain updated. That's Institute and department, yeah, Institute and department supports them in the academic development.
Okay. Sir, how do you tend to build an industry connect with this program?
Yes. With the advent of globalization and opening of Indian economy to outside world, competitions among industries have become stiff. To solve their engineering problems, they look up now to engineering institutes. Similarly, there is an urgent need to prepare engineering students for jobs in multinational companies by exposing them to newer technologies and engineering methodologies. These objectives can only be achieved well by bridging the gap between industry and academic institutes. For holistic development of teachers and students, for bridging this gap between industry and institute, under the guidance of Honorable Chairman of Dhole Patil Education Society, Sri Sagar Dhole Patil, our college has started Industry Institute Interaction Cell. Through this cell, we are making the contacts with industry.
Okay. Sir, what were the challenges that you have faced while inculcating this program in your curriculum?
Well, getting and retaining excellent faculty as per the trends and requirement of industry is a challenge every institute is facing. Recruiting such faculty is our highest priority. If it is not fulfilled in-house, we call industry experts and try to deliver best possible to the students. Ultimate goal is to prepare the students for the competition, which they have to face in the world.
Okay. Sir, what are the different types of projects that the students are working on through these programs?
Yeah. Projects based on IoT, robotics, embedded systems, instrumentation, control systems, image processing, machine learning, etc. Actually, this list is unending. We encourage the students for industry-sponsored or live industrial projects. It also helps them for internship and placement.
Okay, sir. Sir, moving on to the last question of the day. What are the benefits and career options after pursuing this course?
Well, this is the very much required, this knowledge of this question. Okay. The biggest benefit of choosing electronics and telecommunication is the freedom. The freedom of switching between hardware field and software field. After pursuing this course, the students may choose one of the three. First, placement in core industry, service industry, software industry, government or public or private sector. Okay, any one of the field he can choose. The second thing he can do is higher education. And third is the entrepreneurship.
Okay, that's a great insight about the courses and about Dhole Patil College of Engineering. I hope the students who will be viewing this video in future will get an ample amount of information about Dhole Patil College of Engineering and with ENTC department as well.